So within this rapidly growing digital age, many companies and brands have latched themselves onto YouTube. They make these super formulaic series in the attempt to go viral, and yeah, they're pretty good at it. It feels like there's always some big corporation on the trending page. You've got everything from musicians lip-syncing their music in a car, to celebrities lip-syncing other people's music on late night, and then you have the riveting celebrities read Google searches for 5 minutes, and then how could I forget celebrities go on Tinder and make fun of people. You can see that I'm a little bitter when it comes to this kind of thing. I just prefer YouTube as more of a Wild West sort of setting, and now it feels like they only push content that has the backing of these massive companies. They just find some boring concept, use famous people that don't seem interested whatsoever, and boom, trending, millions of views, and so on. I just think it's a little gross. But most of the time, these videos don't bother me. Hey, if they feature somebody I like, I'll probably even enjoy them a little bit. But there's one of these videos that came out recently that I haven't been able to get out of my head. GQ is a huge company that has been pushing out this brand of YouTube content for a while now. They have a few different series that they're currently making. We have 10 things that a celebrity can't live without, which, like, who cares, but whatever. You have somebody that has a lot of jewelry showing off their jewelry. I mean, sure, maybe some people find that interesting. There's the series where celebrities go quote-unquote undercover and look at what people say to them online. And finally, the moment we've all been waiting for, their series where actors, actresses, musicians, and so on break down their most iconic moments. Now, this can be somewhat interesting. I'm obsessed with artists, their process, and I love hearing a behind-the-scenes look at what they thought of a given role, how they liked working with a certain director, how a musician came to a certain sound, whatever. And now, before I get to the video at hand, I just want to mention another video I saw in this series. They had legendary director Spike Lee on to talk about his film heroes, and it legitimately seemed like he was going to fall asleep during the segment.
FDR, Hitler, Eleanor Roosevelt, Goebbels.
Okay, but now to the video that I'm talking about here. A little while ago, GQ put out one of these breaking down iconic stuff videos with Kid Cudi. Specifically, the title is Kid Cudi Breaks Down His Most Iconic Tracks. This one actually seemed like it would be really great. Within interviews and whatnot, Cudi has always seemed super genuine. He's a really intellectual guy that has a deep love for music, art, and personally, I just love the way he speaks too. He did a TED Talk a while back, and I always watch that every now and then. And just to speak on Cudi in general, he's easily one of the most influential musicians and figures of my generation. People around my age love Kid Cudi. A Kid Named Cudi, Man on the Moon 1 and 2 were definitely defining projects for me when I really started to obsess over music. Even with a couple of flops every now and then, he's managed to stay relevant and continued to make great music a decade into his career. And then I watched the GQ video, and I could not have been more disappointed. Not in Cudi, he was great and humble and super interesting to listen to as always, but let's just run through how much of a mess this video from GQ is. So the first song they have him discuss is Reborn off of Kids See Ghosts, and this is really the only song on the list that I don't have a problem with. Reborn's probably my favorite song of the year so far, Kids See Ghosts is incredible, and this project is the most recent thing that Cudi's worked on. Just in terms of these videos being marketing ploys and ways of promotion, of course he's gonna talk about Kids See Ghosts a little bit. So Reborn makes sense, cool, moving on. Next, they have him talk about Cudi Montage, again, off of Kids See Ghosts. This addition to the list is just pretty strange. Again, let me reiterate, this video is called Kid Cudi Breaks Down His Most Iconic Tracks, and halfway through the video, we're mentioning two songs from his most recent project, and specifically, it's a joint project with Kanye West. Having two songs from Kid Cudi Ghosts would even be strange if the video was about the most iconic collaborations between Kid Cudi and Kanye West. Even then, we could pick and choose from a bunch of songs that they've worked on together. Why pick two from the same project? And also, while there obviously aren't too many songs on Kid Cudi Ghosts, Cudi Montage wasn't even one of the better performing songs on the album commercially. I feel like they included this just because it has Cudi's name in the title. As you'll see with the rest of this list, it just feels offensive to his legacy not to do the proper research here. The next song they have him talk about is where I go from being a little weirded out to downright angry at this video. They have him discuss Father Stretch My Hands, which isn't even his song. This track is from The Life of Pablo by Kanye, and it certainly wouldn't even belong in a Kanye's Most Iconic Tracks video. So why in the world is it in Kid Cudi's version? And like, yeah, I love Cudi on that song, his chorus is great, but what are we trying to accomplish with this video? Why would you bring in this incredible musician who has made at least two or three super iconic, great projects that were absolute must-listens of that time in hip-hop? At this point in the video, I already had a pretty good sense of what they were trying to do. Kanye has been everywhere in the news lately. Over the past year or so, whether it be with the Trump stuff, the album rollouts, the ridiculous comments, or him just posting weird Rick and Morty pictures all the time, he's been everywhere. And I really think that with this video, they brought in Kid Cudi just to talk about Kanye and get a few extra clicks. We're three songs into this video about Kid Cudi's most iconic tracks, and the songs have been by Kid See Ghosts, and Kanye West. It's disgusting and super disrespectful to a musician that's brought us so much. And then we get to the next song. They literally have the man talk about All of the Lights. Another Kanye song, but this one makes even less sense than the one before. Do you know how many people are featured on All of the Lights, do you? If I even just brought up the title of the song, you probably wouldn't even remember that Cudi's featured. That song has John Legend, The Dream, Ellie Jackson, Alicia Keys, Fergie, Elton John, Drake, Charlie Wilson, Ryan Leslie, Kid Cudi, Rihanna, and literally there's more. And when the single for that song came out, Rihanna was legit the only one that got credited for being featured on it. Kid Cudi didn't even get credited for being on the song because his contribution is so small, yet GQ has him talking about it as one of his most iconic tracks of all time. I don't even know what to say. It's gross. Kid Cudi has brought so much to music over time. Three of his early solo projects are iconic, they're genre-defining, so influential, and none of them got the time of day here. If these projects didn't come out, I would promise you that a ton of great rappers and artists wouldn't have come out with some of their best material. So to close out this video, I just want to play a few of the songs that should have been mentioned here. There's so many that you could choose from, and personally, I'm going to mention the songs that I think are a good blend of what was popular and high quality. From the early days of A Kid Named Cudi, they could have included the timeless, beautiful songs like The Prayer. And if I die before I wake, or 50 Ways to Make a Record. How you want to be seen, there must be 50 ways to make a record. From the absolute masterpiece that is Man on the Moon, The End of Day, you could have talked about Pursuit of Happiness. I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything is shining. Or Soundtrack to My Life. I've got some issues that nobody can see, and all. And from there, you could have talked about Mr. Rager from Man on the Moon 2. Now, hey, Mr. Rager, tell me. Just What I Am from Indica. And sure, I'm happy with the inclusion of Reborn. I'm so reborn. Let me know what songs you would have included. I'm gonna go cool down because I got strangely mad about this. See you guys. Hey, thanks so much for watching this video. Remember to like and subscribe if you want more videos like this. If you want to follow my social media, the links are down below. You can also donate to my Patreon, help the show, and get some cool rewards if you click the link on the screen. And I sell merch at tpublic.com/user/alfomedia. Thanks for watching, and always forward.